What's up, everybody? It's your favorite. I always thought if maybe this was a inside joke at the American Barbie doll market. Favorite nerd, and today we are looking at the SH Figuarts Street Fighter Ken. As we've come to expect, there's an awful lot of accessories to get into. Let's not wait any longer. So he comes with a few additional hands, two I'm gonna get you hands and one pointing hand. And then he comes with two extra faces, one, chicks are gonna dig this car face, and one, she keyed my car face. And then he comes with the flaming uppercut sort of effect, which is a variation of orange translucence from a light orange to a dark orange throughout. And it looks pretty good. My kids are acting like animals upstairs, but other than that, this looks pretty good. And then he also comes with the backdrops that we've kind of come to expect, which I personally don't need, but I'm sure some people really, really enjoy them. And if you do, don't worry, they're there. All right, as far as the figure is concerned, there's something I gotta talk about. I'm not crazy about the face. Like, something looks wrong, really wrong to me about this face. I can't put my finger on it. It's in the eyes, but it just, I think maybe he looks too young. Joe mentioned that, and now I can't unsee it, but I'm not crazy about it. The paint is done well, and they're shading into the hair, which looked nice. Head-wise, it looks like a double ball peg. Let me see if I can't take some of this stuff apart. How does this come up? There we go. This is how you take the face off anyway. We'll put on a different face. So we're gonna untab this. We're going to tab in the smirky smirk face. It's a double ball peg. I thought so. And then we'll tab this back in. And I think I like that a little bit better, but I'm still not 100% sold. I don't know. Double ball peg in from the head into the neck, and then from the neck into the chest. There's shading on the neck as well. The articulation is great. Head all the way down to there. Up to there, swivel, confused dog look, etc. No issues. Double ball peg in the abdomen, or the chest, into the abdomen, and then the abdomen into the chest, you can see, is a single, it might be a double. So it might be two doubles, which gets you a lot of articulation, bent pretty far over and back. You will have to cover down on the joint, side to side, and swivel. We have a disc hinge in the shoulder, connected to a ball peg into the chest. And then we have a red cover down piece, which I guess you have to do for the butterfly, but you will find in certain poses it will look a little off-putting, especially when you can see it underneath this flap here. But I guess it's the cost of doing business. You can get the arm out to there. It's a tight joint, I'll say. And then around with no problem. No bicep swivel. You do get one at the elbow, so that's fine. And you get a little bit at the shoulder as well. And there's shading on the flesh at the shoulder. Double jointed elbow that gets you the full range. And then the wrist, which you've come to expect, with a ball hinge that gets you in out. Or you can swivel it and then swivel the wrist, which is its own joint, and get up down. As for the gloves, they are an extra piece, it feels like. They might be sculpted on. They might be sculpted on, actually. They're painted orange, and then looks like airbrushed, and then same for the gloves. They look to be airbrushed as well. Hard to tell, though. For the gi, there's a shading of dark red on it. The rest of it is digitally sculpted. The wrinkles and stuff look nice. And then you have this floating piece here, which you're mainly going to use to cover down on the joints. And then the belt does swivel for articulation. Now, for the hips, you have universals. There's also a cover down piece. So rotating both, you can get the leg all the way out to there, so that's not an issue. Back to there, that's not an issue. Thigh swivel around the universal, so that's perfect. You have shading in the pants, and then you have a knee at a knee hinge, a little bit past 90 degrees. The wrinkles in the pants look nice around the base of the foot as well. The foot itself is on a disc hinge. You get ankle tilt down to there, up to there, it swivels, and you have a toe hinge, and you have a rocker where it plugs into the foot. So you shouldn't have any articulation issues whatsoever. There he is from the back. Negatives-wise, it's a matter of subjectivity. Outside of that, it's fine. For me, it just feels a little kiddie. Now, I know that they all have an animated kind of look and feel, but he seems like he's out of a kid's cartoon to me. It just doesn't seem to have that real kind of... the same kind of effect, like almost the mature manga look of the others. I feel like this one looks like more out of a more children's-oriented cartoon. Maybe a, I don't know, more Dragon Ball than Ghost in the Shell. I know that doesn't really relate exactly to what I'm saying, but I hope you get the idea. He just looks awfully young, and I'm not sure how I feel about that. I know I don't feel 100% great, but there is a lot of great things about it. The paint is great throughout. The sculpt is great throughout, with the exception of the face. I feel like it's a little too skinny and a little too childish. The articulation is great throughout, and he looks good with the rest of them. So if you like the way the head looks, so to speak, I think you'll be happy with them. If you're not crazy about the head sculpt, there's nothing in hand that's going to save that. So do with that as you will. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care.